Can you guess what's wrong with this code? We're using the property wrapper at stateObject to store a viewModel. But because the viewModel needs an argument to be initialized, we can't give it its initial value directly at its declaration. Instead, we have to do it in the initializer of the view. To do so, we first create the viewModel, then we put it in a stateObject wrapper, and finally, we assign it to the underlying variable of the property wrapper. And you might have noticed that because we want to avoid long lines of code, we've stored the intermediary result in a local variable. But as it turns out, in this precise situation, storing the intermediate result in a local variable is actually a mistake that opens the door for very subtle bugs. That might seem confusing, but let me explain. To understand what's happening, we need to take a look at the signature of the stateObject wrapper initializer. As you can see, its argument is annotated with @autoclosure. This information wasn't visible at the call site, but it's really important. What autoclosure means is that the argument that we pass will be automatically wrapped inside a closure. And then the stateObject wrapper will make sure that this closure is only called once during the entire lifetime of the view. This is really important because this is what guarantees that our viewModel won't be recreated every time that the view gets updated. Now that we've understood this, let's go back to our call site. Since we're only passing our local variable to the initializer of stateObject, it means that the stateObject wrapper won't be able to manage the code that instantiates the viewModel itself. As a result, every time that the initializer of the view is executed, a new viewModel will be created. But since the stateObject initializer makes sure to execute the closure only once during the entire lifetime of the view, all these extra viewModels will never be stored inside the stateObject, and instead will be immediately released from memory. This means that in the best scenario, this code is being wasteful by instantiating viewModels which will never be used. And in the worst scenario, if the initializer of the viewModel has any side effects, these side effects will be executed more than they should, which can lead to very subtle bugs. So remember, whenever you need to instantiate a stateObject wrapper yourself, make sure that you pass the full initialization code as its argument. That's all for this video. I hope that you've enjoyed learning about this very tricky behavior of stateObject. I've actually learned about it myself from a great blog article. I've put the link in the description if you want to check it out. As always, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss the next ones. Thank you for watching and see you next time.